The $150 Texas Instruments TI-Inspire graphing calculator has quickly become one of the moral standards for mathematics and scientific classes here in the U.S. A lot of school districts and states are requiring this device and ordering these devices directly from Texas Instruments to put in the classroom for students to use. Outside of it, it's also one of the most advanced and powerful graphing calculators ever manufactured. This is all due to the intensive display, processor, control navigational system, and the fact that the UI is super intuitive and easy to use. From the design standpoint, it's quite a large graphing calculator. It's well maneuvered, and it has a good grip on both sides. It feels sturdy, although it's made out of this rough plastic, no metals, which is pretty good. It's kind of heavy, though, so it's not going to be something too easy to carry around, you know, in a pocket or jeans or anything like that. Although you won't be doing that for much. So on the device, you'll see a very spacious monochrome display. The monochrome screen is nice in contrast. Everything looks very sharp, and all the features are both easy to see and both easy to use. The screen, too, reflects a lot of glare due to this anti-glare film. Viewing angles are very good, and the only thing we would complain about is there's no backlight, although it's great for the battery life. Classrooms should provide adequate sunlight. Below the navigational screen, you'll find a touchpad. Now, this is where the TI Inspire or TI touchpad gets its name. You have this capacitive touchpad, which responds to your finger and flesh only, which is a good thing because it means it's the same type of technology that's utilized in iPhones, which is very sensitive. By maneuvering from the home screen, a mouse appears, and you can move the mouse around to activate on different things. In the settings, you can adjust the sensitivity of the touchpad to whether you want to just tap it once to access a feature or to actually press down the actual tactile button controls in order to access it. If you don't like the idea of using a touchpad, this is a button, like we said, it's a hardware button, so that we can press down and to access it using a standard 5-way navigation toggle. On the other sides of this button, you'll find an escape button to go back out of an application or a menu system. We have this is called the, basically this is going to be our scratch pad, and you press this little flying calculator icon in order to access, yes, the scratch pad, which is where you can calculate quick calculations without saving the documents. So it's basically like, okay, I'm solving this very intricate matrices, or I'm doing this very hard calculus equation, and I have one part of it that I want to solve, in particular, maybe a basic operational thing, like, 5 divided by 622, or something like that. I can just directly press this whatever menu I'm in, pressing this button takes you to the scratch pad to immediately perform that calculation. It's really easy to use, and you would just use the buttons down below, which are really large, and the number buttons are spacious and easy to press. The buttons on the sides are more tactile and a little bit more smaller, so definitely this is a advanced calculator, so make sure that you don't accidentally press anything, or you can just press escape to go out of it. The buttons are all risen above the surface and fairly easy to text and dial, definitely to press along the way. On the bottom, you'll find a full array of keyboards for naming equations like x, y's, intercepts, and things like that. The keyboard below is really tactile. The buttons are really minisc, and they're pretty small, but they have this really cool sound when you press them. They're easy to press, and the response is fairly fast. Unfortunately, it's not in QWERTY layout, and rather in this ABC layout, which definitely slows down calculations, considering a lot of people these days are used to the QWERTY layouts from their smartphones. That's kind of a disappointment. It's kind of weird, though, too, because the only reason they went with this design was so that it will be a usable product on the SAT. This is SAT certified. But it's weird that the SAT would allow a keyboard and not allow in QWERTY layout. So it's like you're typing anyways, right? But that's just something to note. So pressing the flying calculator button again takes you to the same scratch pad screen, but it goes into the graphing function. So if you want to graph a parabola, like a, x squared plus 5x plus 5, we can graph that and see if it will pop up on screen. If it doesn't, we need to zoom out or zoom in, depending on the location of the graph. And for the most part, this is very easy to use, and all you need to do is press the menu or the document button. In this case, the menu button you need to go to the zoom function, and if you want to go to zoom out, you can just press that button and directly zoom out. This is a very highly advanced calculator, so you'll find that functions are really intuitive and easy to use. That said, there is slight sluggishness when performing advanced functions that should be updated with UIs that will be coming in the future from TI Inspire, from TI's lineup directly. So, from the menu, you can also see that this device is optimized for different full functions, like under documents, you can create a new document which you can calculate and save if the teacher needs it. Speaking of teachers, there is also a mode called Test Press, and what that happens is it disables certain features your teacher doesn't want you to use on tests, and when you do that, the calculator is limited to a test mode. That's pretty cool, and when it is in test mode, this is an LCD that blinks green when it is in this press to test mode. It's very easy to use, very easy to activate, very easy to disable, and it's just pretty cool that it includes this very cool LED and feature that makes it very intuitive in the classroom as well. So it seems to be a very well-planned and thought-out device with a full back suite of softwares and UIs advancing in the future. On the bottom right of the device, you'll find navigational hotkeys to the calculator page, the new document page, and a various settings and graphs and functions that you can do with this device. So overall, what do we think of this device? It's a fairly advanced calculator with a appreciable set of features, which makes it one of the most powerful and intuitive, easy on the mind UIs that we've seen in a very long time. Everything is going to be simple to use. If you don't understand it, there's a huge manual you can read. And so the TI Inspire is certainly well worth the money, even though it's a little bit of an investment. On the back, you'll find the battery slot, which it runs on AA batteries, or you can purchase a rechargeable lithium iron battery. Thank you for watching this video review at osmbtxreviews.com.